Good morning, boys and girls. And how are you this morning? It's good that you have chosen to join us for this service, your service actually, where we learn about God's word, and God's word is true. It never changes. And though sometimes we struggle with what's happening around us, it doesn't change. So let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this day that you have given to us. We are looking forward to hearing what you have to say to us this day, because you are not only our Creator, but you are the Father of all the children who love you through your Son, Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, as we listen to our story today, please help us to be still, to listen, and that your Holy Spirit will also allow us to understand, because there's nothing too difficult for you. Thank you, God. For this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Wow. Okay, I hope your week has been good. I hope you have continued to do what you've been asked to do by the government, because that is also choosing obedience. And if you can obey there, then it's not even difficult to obey God. Right, so before we get on with our story this morning, I just wanted us to review what has been our storyline before I tell you what we are going to discover today as we go through the Bible. We've been walking in a journey, and the journey has been about the kingdom of Israel and Judah. And we have talked about prophets and a good king. And I'll remind you that Teacher Jabi spoke to us not too long ago about a prophet called Micah. And the prophet called Micah had something to tell the people and a lesson for us as well. He was telling the people that they were not doing the right thing. And we agreed, and you were told that prophets hear from God and then they have to speak to the people. So they hear what God needs to be said, and then they tell the people. But the catch is this: they don't add or take away anything, whether it sounds good or bad. It's spoken as is. Real hard work for a prophet, because sometimes God is really saying something that people don't want to hear, but they don't have permission not to share the information. So Micah tells the people that they are not doing the right thing and that God is going to judge them. Right? And then there was a lesson. So what does God want us to do? And the lesson was, God wants us to obey him because we love him. That's the catch. You need to love God in order to obey him. Right, then we moved on, and Teacher Jackton shared with us about, wow, that young king, 8 years old. Most of you are probably there. 8 years old was King Josiah's age when he was given kingship. And he was very, very sure what he wanted to do. He wanted people to obey God. So he removed all the places that were upsetting God, where the people had started praying to idols. He brought everything down. And he pressed on and made sure that the people of Judah obeyed God and his word, and they worshiped him. Right, and last Sunday, there was this story about what will happen on the day of the Lord. You remember that? That was with Teacher Violet. Ah, yes, and that was the prophet called Zephaniah. So we have two prophets, one king. Zephaniah said to the people, there is coming a day of the Lord. Are you ready for the day of the Lord? That's what she asked. And then what will happen on the day of the Lord? And she gave us an answer. God will judge sinners and save those who trust in Jesus. God will judge sinners and save those who trust in Jesus. Those were our three lessons as we journeyed through the kingdom of Judah. And we keep pressing on, and we keep pressing on. Today, we are going to look at another prophet. His name is Habakkuk. Let's say it together. Habakkuk. Right. And he has a book in the Bible with his name, Habakkuk. Now, it's a book that has only three chapters. And I'm sure that if you work on it, you can actually read the three chapters for yourself. So, what do we want to answer today? Our question is, what do we do when it seems that God isn't listening? Do you ever think that God isn't listening to your prayer? I certainly do, because many times I want my prayer answered like right now. I want things to go away like right now. I want the answer like right now. Or when I wake up tomorrow morning, it's gonna happen. Or by the time I get to the mall, something has already happened. Waiting, this thing of waiting. That's our big picture today. So what do we do when it seems, the golden word there is, when it seems God isn't listening? Let's read now. Let's read from the book of Habakkuk, and we'll get the gist of this story as we go along. So Habakkuk wasn't like meant to go and tell the people anything. He had a problem with what was happening around him. He looked and there was trouble. He looked and there were people killing. He looked and things were not going right. So there was injustice. I mean, things were just not right in Judah. And he was really struggling with all of this. And being a prophet, you would understand that he's struggling, right? Because he's hoping that, having heard what Micah had said and King Josiah had done and Zephaniah had said, you're thinking, guys, you've been told so many times, why don't you get the hang of it? So Habakkuk is now talking to God, and so he's asking God, and we are going to read. Please open your Bibles. I have a kid's Bible today. It's called the NIRV Adventure Bible, but it's a Bible. Now you open your Bible to the book of Habakkuk. It's a little book, three chapters. And I know you guys are going to read it. By the time we meet for the Sunday school fellowship in the afternoon, I'm sure you guys would have read it. Right. So let's hear what Habakkuk is saying to God. This is really important. He's talking to God and he's saying, I will read from Habakkuk chapter 1, verses 2. He's asking, Lord, how long do I have to call out for help? Why don't you listen to me? How long must I keep telling you that things are terrible? Why don't you save us? Why do you make me watch while people treat each other so unfairly? Why do you put up with all these wrong things that they are doing? I, and that's Habakkuk, I have to look at death. People are killing one another. People are harming each other. And they are arguing and fighting all the time. The law, which is the government of that day, can't do what it's supposed to do. Fairness never comes out on top. Sinful people surround those who do what is right. And so people never get treated fairly. That's what Habakkuk told God. And that was from verses 2 to verses 4. That's what Habakkuk has told God. And then Habakkuk receives an answer from God. Listen to this. That's how you know that God is God, and when he answers at the right time, he doesn't necessarily answer what you want to hear, but he answers nonetheless. So let's read verses 5 and following. So the Lord replies, verses 5. So the Lord replies, look at the nations, watch them, be totally amazed at what you see. I am going to do something in your days that you'd never believe. You would not believe it even if someone told you about it. Listen to this. Verses 6. I am going to send the armies of Babylon to attack you. Oopsie. That's not what Habakkuk had in mind. That's not what he had in mind. He probably thought, oh, you're going to send a good king, or you're going to send, I mean, something different. But God was going to send the Babylonians. Now, those guys were known in those days to be really bad guys. I mean, they had an army that just mentioning the word Babylon used to bring fear in the hearts of men. Listen how that goes. They are very mean. This is what the Bible is saying. We continue to read. So I am going to send the armies of Babylon to attack you. They are very mean. They move quickly. They sweep across the whole earth. They take over places that do not belong to them. Woof. Oh, they terrify others. I mean, it goes on and on. It's not a good thing. I'm going to leave you to read that for yourselves. But you get the gist of it. I mean, these guys are bad. These guys are bad. It's like having real big tanks going out in our day. And this is not what Habakkuk is thinking, that shouldn't be the answer. I mean, these guys are worse than us in Judah. Why? I mean, he's thinking, why, God? Why are you going to send those guys? All right. Nonetheless, God has answered. Habakkuk doesn't like it. So he has another session with God, and he asks another question. Let's skip over to 12. Where Habakkuk is asking God another question. And he says, Lord, haven't you existed forever? And this asking, girls and boys, is not asking as in, I know more than you. I'm just asking, I thought this is how it should be. But let me ask anyway. So this is what, that's how Habakkuk is asking, like in a state of confusion, because God is a good and righteous God. That's what he knows. That's what you and I know. So when I'm asking about the disobedience of Judah, I'm asking, Lord, so you can put it right for us. You have ways of doing it. It's almost like he has an answer for God, but he's being careful because he knows, as a prophet, that God is over all and is everything. So, here goes another question. So, Lord, Haven't you existed forever? You are a holy God. So we won't die, will we? Lord, you have appointed the Babylonians to punish your people, he included Judah. My rock, you have chosen them to judge us. Now Babylon were wicked people, wicked. They didn't even know about Jehovah God, whom the Israelites worshipped. They were just bad guys. So Habakkuk is struggling with all this. So Judah is disobeying. Habakkuk asks God a question. How long is this gonna continue? How long? And then the Lord answers and says, actually, I know what's been happening. I've been watching, and I'm going to send the Babylonians. That's the answer. Habakkuk is a bit confused about that. So, disobedience, a holy God, wicked people. Okay, this is not adding up. But anyway, Habakkuk says, because he's been told to look and watch, that's what he does. So when we skip over to chapter 2, in his heart he's thinking, okay, I need to watch. God has said he's going to do something about all of this. So he promises himself and tells God that I will go to the outlook tower. So that's like being a watchman. You see, Judah was surrounded with a wall. So there was a wall where they would watch for enemies coming, right? That's what happened. It's like us guys. We've got walls where we live in gated communities so that a watchman would actually be posted. So he says, I will go and I'll be like the watchman. And I will station myself on the city wall, and I will wait and see what the Lord's reply will be to me. So he accepts that God is all in all. When God says he's gonna do something, he keeps his promise. And Habakkuk also realizes that God is in control of everything. So Habakkuk goes to the wall, and I think as he sits there, and that's a place where all of us must learn to do, is to wait. And waiting sometimes can be very difficult. Ask me. Sometimes I'm in traffic and I'm late, and I'm thinking, I want to run those lights. I really do. And then something just says, mm-mm. You got to wait for the amber light. Don't jump the lights, right? Waiting. Or let's say you go and it's terrific Tuesday, terrific Thursday, and you're thinking, we ordered for our pizza like 15 minutes, we were told 20 minutes, it's taking longer than, and you're thinking, where's our pizza? Where's our pizza? You know, that thing? It helps to wait. So Habakkuk realizes there is need to wait, and he chooses to wait on God, having realized that God is in control of everything. And when God says he's gonna take care of it, he's gonna take care of it. Remember, he was going to take care of Judah because of their disobedience. He was also going to take care of Babylon because they were wicked. But God was going to use Babylon to punish Judah. And that also doesn't kind of sound right-ish, but look at it this way. Why would God use a good person to punish somebody who's doing the wrong thing? He will use a bad person who already has bad issues to punish And if this person goes beyond what God has told them, he also deals with that person's wickedness, right? So that kind of sounds okay. And I think Habakkuk realized, you know what, guys? I'm going to wait. You know what, God? I'm going to wait. I'm going to go and wait and see what you will do. And at verses 4 in chapter 2, because the Babylonians were not good people, God replies, chapter 2, verses 2, God replies to Habakkuk, having said that he's going to go and wait. He tells Habakkuk, write down the message I am showing you in a vision. Write it clearly on the tablets you use. So Habakkuk was a writer. He needed to write this information so he doesn't get lost. And that's how even you and I today are able to read this information. A messenger can read it and run to announce it. Let's read that again. Then a messenger can read it and run to announce it. The message I give to you, wait for the time I have appointed. There's a golden word again. Wait for the time I have appointed. I speak about what is going to happen, and all of it will come true. It might take a while, but wait for it. You can be sure it will come to pass. It will happen when I want it to. God replies Habakkuk from a place of waiting. So, boys and girls, the question again, what do we do when it seems God isn't listening? What do we do when it seems? That's the word we need to think about, when it seems that God isn't listening. Clearly, we can see from this story, God has listened to everything Habakkuk has said and actually responded. The response is not what Habakkuk was looking forward to, but it's answered nonetheless. So in closing, God actually always answers our prayers. He does. But we need to wait. We need to wait. We actually need to wait. So during this season of COVID-19, a good time to teach us how to wait, isn't it? Let's not panic that the president has not said. Let's not panic and take things into our own hands because school won't reopen. Let's just wait. And it's a good place to ask God real tough questions. And God really wants to hear those tough questions that you and I have. He actually is concerned. So it's okay. Talk to God and then wait. Don't be in a hurry. Wait. Now, in closing, and I'll scoot off to chapter 3, and I will read verses 2. Just verse 2. Habakkuk has waited. Habakkuk has written a message. He's asked all his questions. And then he just is at peace with everything because he realizes that God is in absolute control. And this is what Habakkuk says back to the Lord. He says, Lord, I know how famous you are. I have great respect for you because of your mighty acts. Do them again for us. Make them known in our time. But when you are angry, please show mercy. Please, please show mercy. And why was he saying that? Because he knew Judah was disobedient and he had talked to God about Judah. He got a response that the wicked Babylonians are the ones who are going to come and sort out Judah and take them off to exile, right? But God was also going to deal with the wickedness of the Babylonians because he also knew about their wickedness. So when we say that God is in control of the good and what seems to be the bad, for him, all things are in his hands. And I know as human beings, we can't even figure it out. We think everything should be how I want. But then that is to suggest that you don't recognize that there is a God. So it's important that we recognize there is a God. He will judge disobedience. He will also judge wickedness, right? That's a cut and dry thing. Yeah, that will happen. That will happen. So God is always in control. Now, I guess that's it, guys. That's actually it. But before we go, let me ask a few questions. And this is how we're going to do it this time. You're going to get your I'm hoping you've got your notebook and Bible. And I will give you the questions. And imagine I'll also give you the answer. The answer where you'll find the answer. So you'll do some homework. And when we meet for our fellowship, I'll see how many of us have done our homework, right? So let's do question one. What did Habakkuk seem to think that God wasn't doing? What was his problem here? So Habakkuk is praying and then he's saying, God, how come? Now the answer is in chapter 1, verse 2. That's where you'll find your answer. So what did Habakkuk say that God wasn't doing? It's found in Habakkuk chapter 1, verse 2. The second question. Who did God say would take Judah away into captivity? Who did God say he was going to use to punish Judah? That's more likely the question. Who did God say he would use to punish Judah? And that answer is found in chapter 1, verse 6. Right? Next. Why did Habakkuk think that God's choice was unfair? Why did Habakkuk think that God's choice was unfair? That's found in chapter 1, verses 13. Chapter 1, verse 13. And then the final question, not the final question, second from last question. In the end, what did Habakkuk agree to do? In the end, what did Habakkuk agree to do? Now that one, I haven't read for you. So this is really going to be the golden question to see who is going to read their Bible. In the end, what did Habakkuk agree to do? I want you to pick the answer from chapter 3, verses 17 to 19. Yeah? Right. Now, the final question, and Mike is gonna do a drum roll for us. There comes a drum roll. Okay, the fifth and final question. What do we do when it seems that God isn't listening? What do we do when it seems that God isn't listening? Now this, I will give you the answer. We trust that God will take care of those who love Him. We trust that God will take care of those who love Him. The golden word right there is love Him. Love is the golden word. Right? Great. Our questions all done? Our questions are all done. Now, we've been doing a scripture verse for quite a while now. We've been doing a scripture verse for quite a while now. It's found in Zephaniah. It is found in Zephaniah 3:17. And this is what it says. The Lord your God is with you, the mighty warrior who saves. He will take great delight in you. In his love, he will no longer rebuke you, but will rejoice over you with singing. Zephaniah 3:17. Did you get that? We'll put it up for you. Zephaniah 3:17. There you go. There, it's up. Let's read it together. The Lord your God is with you, the mighty warrior who saves. He will take great delight in you. In his love, he will no longer rebuke you, but will rejoice over you with singing. Zephaniah 3:17. And that is our scripture verse for this Sunday. It's my prayer that you will read the three chapters. It's good to read for yourself. You get a nice little Bible and read it. And where the words are difficult, ask mom, dad, grandpa, grandma, auntie, a sibling to help. But read. It helps to read the word for yourself. So thank you. You guys have a great week. Continue doing what honors God. And God willing, we will see you again next Sunday. Bye.